Today I'm going to do some modulation analysis in SimCenter Test Lab. I'm going to use SimCenter Test Lab Neo Process Designer to do this. I'm going to use the Universal View. And under File here, I'm going to make sure that under Add-ins, I have the Sound Quality Analysis add-in loaded and the Interactive Analysis. And then I'm going to open a project with some data to analyze. In this project, I have a few sets of data. One of the sets are two different sine waves. And if I hit Shift-O, I can un-overlay them. And if I zoom in a bit, we can take a look at these sine waves. You can see that at some points, the two are in phase. These two sine waves are 500 and 505 hertz, so they're slightly different. So that means over time, at some other point, they'll be out of phase, like you see here. And so they add and subtract from each other over time because they're at slightly different frequencies. If I was to do something like do a little math on them, so I'll grab the calculate method, and I'm going to analyze this with the calculate method. So I'm going to put them in the input basket. And in calculate, I'm going to pick the formula set area here, and I can create a formula. I'm going to add channel 1 to channel 2, and we can call that the sum. I'll hit run, and the data is put in this active analysis. Now I have three time histories, and we can see that the sum doubles in amplitude and goes to 0. And if we listen to this, I'll back out a little bit further. Nice steady tone. Steady tone. But the sum is modulated. So that modulation is what we tend to hear. And we can see if we were to look at this data, and we looked at about the first second, there's about 5 modulations per second. So a question would be like, I want to understand that modulation frequency. Maybe I'd grab a spectrum here, and then I would want to do an FFT on this data. So I'd set some FFT parameters, and I'll go back to processing, reanalyze. Take a look at the spectrum, and if I look at this spectrum, well, I know there's like 5 modulations per second because I just heard it, but I see frequencies of 500 and 505 hertz. I don't see anything at 5 hertz. So the question would be, how do we know what the modulation frequency is? The trick is to use something called an envelope. Grab the envelope here, and we can take the output of this, take it into the envelope, and put the envelope back over here. And then the envelope, do a full bandwidth. I'll hit reject and rerun this. And if I look back at the time signals, here I have the envelope and the original time signal. If I use Shift-O, I can overlay those, and we could see that the green, which is the envelope of the sum, definitely has a lot lower frequency content. If I take a look at the FFT of those, you can see that the original sum has 500 and 505, and the FFT of the envelope has a 5 hertz component. And so the trick into understanding when we have a modulation phenomena, what the frequency of the modulation is to use an envelope analysis and then do an FFT of it to understand that. Okay, so hopefully that made sense. I'm going to delete those here. I have some other signals. I have a sweep here, and I'll just take a look at this first of all. This sweep goes from, it consists of two tones, goes for 30 seconds, and the two tones start out 1 hertz apart and end up at 20 hertz apart. That's what this sum is. So I'm going to put that in the input basket, and then maybe I'll do a regular FFT on this, or a spectral map. Spectral map, I'll do 0.1 second increments, a 1 hertz resolution. I'll hit run here, take a look at the active analysis, take a look at this color map, and we can see if we look at it here, yep, there are 2 tones. And indeed, if I like go to the top end here and line up my 2 cursors on here and take a look at the axis range, they're about 20 hertz apart at the end of the recording and much closer together, 1 hertz apart at the beginning. So that is a modulation that changes over time. One thing we can use to analyze this is something called a modulation map. So I'll rerun this again. But now I'll have a modulation map as well as a regular map. And if I hold down the mouse and click on both of these, I'll see them side by side. Here we have our data that's 20 hertz apart, the original 2 sine tones. The modulation map, same time instance, has a 20 hertz separation in it. Starts with a 1 hertz separation, goes up to 20 hertz separation. So the modulation map shows me the modulation frequency present in the data over time and can track it as it changes. I can grab this thing called modulation frequency, also add that here. And if I was to include this in the analysis, I should get an additional piece of information. So here I had the original color map, then I had the modulation color map, and then I have modulation frequency. And you can see here it starts from 1, goes up to 20. So it's telling me what the modulation frequency is, or the biggest modulation frequency is over time in that map. And let's maybe take a quick listen to this. Let's look at another set of data here. I have some steady state signals. And we can see they're all on the same scale here. There are different types of modulations. And one of the things that we might be interested in is what is the modulation depth. We can see that this signal goes down to 0, whereas the green signal does not. And same thing with the blue versus the purple. We can also see that the blue and red are a little bit different. It looks like in the case of the blue, it goes to 0, red goes to 0, but red really stays at 0 a little bit longer. It comes out of it more gradually, blue's more, a little more abrupt, so maybe it doesn't modulate as much. So we have in these signals different modulation depths, if you will, how much they actually modulate. We'll take a quick listen here. So red sounds a lot more modulation than green. All right, so let's see what modulation depth will give us for these signals. So I'll hook that up here. We'll put the data in the input basket, and then we'll hit run. Let's take a look at the analysis here. So here's the time signals, and then if we look at the modulation depth, we can see that for these 4 time signals, and this is showing a percentage from 0 to 100%, that I'll make it a little bit higher, in fact, make it easier to see. We can see that the red signal is fully modulated, 100%. Then the blue is the second most, then green, and then purple. And purple had this more gradual modulation versus the green. Just a little bit different in how it was constructed, and these subtle differences are picked up. If I go back to that sweep and grab it, let's see what the modulation depth was throughout that run-up. So I'll hit run, go to the active analysis, grab modulation depth, and you can see that that was a pretty steady state throughout. Another metric that's useful for understanding modulation is something called fluctuation strength. And also analyze that sweep with fluctuation strength. It takes into account some things that modulation depth does not. It's been noticed that people are more sensitive to a modulation that occurs 4 times per second versus 10 times per second, and not very sensitive at 20 times per second. So if I was to grab fluctuation strength and overlay that with modulation depth for the same signal, you can see that the modulation is not constant over time where the modulation depth is. Thank you for listening to this video about modulation metrics in SimCenter TestLab Neo.